That start was okay. Now stay alert for threats around you. Is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. Battery charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy. Okay, gap ahead is 3.4 seconds. Thank you. front is a second a lap faster, 1 second. The battery is low on energy. Reduce ERS deployment. Gap to car in front is 10.4 seconds. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. We expect these tyres to be good for a while yet. Just be careful with them in the high-speed corners. The gap to the car ahead is 14.8 seconds. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs. Okay, we need some energy harvesting. Reduce ERS deployment. Box, we're coming in this lap. This lap, keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach and make sure you don't speed. pit in this lap, and remember the speed limit. We'll be penalized if we exceed it. Keep that in mind as you approach. Okay, at the current pace and fuel settings, we won't have enough fuel for the end of the race. Consider lowering the fuel mix. Expect the tyres are getting a bit worn at this point. You may notice a gradual loss in grip. They should still have a bit left though. Our gap to the car in front is 24.5 seconds. forget, box this lap. Box this lap. Keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach, and make sure you don't speed. Behind is 1.8 seconds. Okay, gap ahead is 31.6 seconds. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. to car in front is 2.2 seconds. Let's turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy. Release! That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Fuel is at target minus one. Let's turn the engine down, please. Blue flag conditions. Create a gap and let the car behind through.
My security ghosted.
The gap to the car ahead is 29.8 seconds. Thank you. gap to the car in front is 29.1 seconds. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Gap ahead is 29.3 seconds. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Uh-oh, Tron.
There's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. Gap to car in front is 29.0 seconds. To consider switching to a lower fuel mix, we may not finish on the current settings. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. Blue flag, blue flag. Conditions. Create a gap and let the car behind through. We've been awarded a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race.
Apparently that didn't count as blue flagging.
Oh, was that you that went off?
Yeah, I was desperately trying to not get lapped by you. Man, really unfortunate for Tron.
Yeah, he dominated.
But yeah, that was me. I did a medium to soft one stop, so I had really good tires towards the end, but I was too far behind Lin since Lin's strategy going onto the hards was better. I think
so
either better case was just
so
better.
Was it just Tron and I that did the one soft, one medium?
No, that's what I just said I did. Well, I did medium soft, you did soft medium.
I did soft hard, which was a mistake. I knew it as soon as I came. I tried so hard to catch you, Sakuri.
Yeah, but yeah. I almost...
I
was So I was in front. I was saving battery and fuel too.
I blue flagged for security, and then I was like right behind you for a couple of laps. And I'm like, oh man, I shouldn't have blue flagged. I could have probably stayed ahead of you because I was so much quicker on my fresh softs, at least for the first couple of laps of that stint. But then I started falling off, and then Lucky started catching me.
I should have stayed out until lap 16.
Yeah, yeah, look. How weird is it that, you know, my pace to yours, Lucky, is like, our fastest laps are only 4/10 off.
Dude, Tron and I have fastest laps on the thousands off. But this is definitely a track he's always been faster than I have been. It's been years now.
Hey, at least I kept the lead for a few laps.
Okay, so here's a funny thing.
Once I saw you on hards, I was like, oh, guy, I remember precisely. I lost a race because of it. I learned that lesson, you know. Yeah.
So, Lucky,
if the difference is like one lap, you're not going to make it, just go for it.
So, when I crashed on the last lap, so I was just basically racing Lucky Moose to try and not get lapped by him. And then I put the gas in a little bit too hard into turn 5 and spun out and damaged my wing. And that gave me multiple warnings, 3-second time penalty. I'm like, oh, come on. I was crashing. I wasn't cutting the corner, I was crashing.
Came out of your pit. I was so close to the undercut. But once you were ahead of me, I knew. Because I had, like, no pace on the hards. I was, like, at least 8/10 off of the medium. And then Tron got by me early on after you passed me.
Well, Lucky, one thing about that race is because Lin was here and I didn't get fourth by default, you've passed me in the championship for third. And boy, do we have a close championship, actually. Sakuri 198, Tron 192. One race to go, right?
One race to go.
So, basically, next race, winner takes all.
That's crazy, because I'm also shit at Abu Dhabi. But, I saw that I barely came out of in front of Lucky.
Yeah, I was right there.
It was crazy like how close it was. And I thought for sure I was going to stay ahead of Tron. For sure, because he was old medium. So I saved a bunch of fuel, bunch of battery, and then, I saw you was on, you were on hard, so I was like, I can't even save battery and fuel, no problem. And then what happened was, he comes out so far ahead of me, it was ridiculous. And his softs were not letting go either.
Yeah, I pitted way too early, but the softs still had a lot of life.
Yeah, I was able. I actually wasn't sure what my wear was at on my softs at the very end, but I could have probably pitted a few laps early on my mediums. But it wouldn't have changed my finishing position since I wasn't closing the gap to Lin Martel nearly fast enough to make it work. Like, he got past me after his pit stop, and then I pitted after him, so I emerged like 30 seconds behind him. And I only managed to pull him back like 10 to 15 seconds by the last lap, and then I spun, and that kind of sealed it. But I wasn't going to make up 15 seconds on the last lap unless Lin made a mistake. Yeah.
So on the hards, I was consistently doing like high 112s.
The only positives of the hards is that they are super consistent.
Yeah, they were like still at 30% wear at the end.
Yeah.
And I put them on lap 13. So.
They're like, in case something happens, you bust the wing and you have to come in lap 7 or something.
Yeah, you had the right strategy. I think if I was on your strategy, then you would
have been
more
way closer. Way, way closer.
But I still only finished like 7 seconds off, which isn't too bad.
No, you had pace. You had pace.
Notice that we never left the practice channel.
Yeah, I mean, if we are all in here, yeah. It works.
I was so nervous at the start not to turn in on it.
Dude, I'm always when I get pulled.
I had the moment with I almost did a Mexico with Tron and break my front wing on him again, so I really had to jam on the brakes when he was ahead of me, and then that let Lin through because I absolutely lost all of my speed going through turn 1, 2, 3, 5, going through turn 4 and 5. They all have names, I should look them up.
It's kind of funny that my pace on softs and hards was about the same.
On our practice, I hopped on the hard and I didn't last one lap. I spun out, so it's like there's no way I can make the hards do anything for me.
Looking at your medium pace, you were consistently like half a second faster. That's where it really hurt me.
And they didn't drop. The medium did not drop at the end. Even the softs were okay for 15 laps. I mean, nothing like fucking Tron's pace. Jeez, man. I mean, in practice, he was half a second faster than me consistently, so it makes sense.
Alright, I'll cut my video here and start uploading it.